Hello students, this is Anthony Christie Melson, Department of Mathematics, BMS College of Engineering. In this presentation, I will be discussing about eigenspaces. To begin with, we'll recollect the definition of eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Given a square matrix A, if there exists a column vector x which is non-zero such that Ax equal to lambda x, then lambda is called the eigenvalue and x is the corresponding eigenvector. Rearranging this, we get A minus lambda I into x equal to 0, which is nothing but a system of linear equations which is homogeneous in nature. So the task of finding lambda, the eigenvalue, is equivalent to finding lambda such that equation 2 has non-trivial solution, and the solution for each value of lambda is called the eigenvector. As we can see from equation 2, x equal to 0 is also an answer when we talk in terms of homogeneous system of equations. But when we say eigenvalues and eigenvectors, we only consider the non-zero vectors or the non-zero solution or non-trivial solution. So the kernel or the null space of A minus lambda I is called the eigenspace of the matrix corresponding to lambda and is denoted by E lambda. When we say kernel or the null space, it means all possible solutions of equation 2, that is, it includes the zero solution also. Therefore, the eigenspace E lambda is the linear combination of all solutions of X. To illustrate, let us consider the mapping T from R3 to R3 given by T of XYZ equal to 2X plus Y, Y minus Z, 2y plus 4z. We can write this in the form of column vector, which is given by equation 1. When we say eigenvalues of a linear transformation, we are talking about the non-trivial or non-zero vector x which satisfies T of x equal to lambda x. We can write equation 1 in the form of a matrix multiplication, which is given by equation 2. Now we have T of x equal to Ax, and for eigenvalues and eigenvectors of T, we have T of x equal to lambda x. Therefore, we have Ax equal to lambda x. So the characteristic equation is given by this expression. Here, TR of A, which is the trace of the matrix, is the sum of the principal diagonal elements. M11, M22, and M33 are the principal minors. And determinant A is 12, so the characteristic equation is given by 3. The roots of the characteristic equation are the eigenvalues. Using a calculator, one can find the two distinct eigenvalues 2 and 3. Since equation 3 is a cubic equation, we should have 3 roots, therefore 3 eigenvalues. The properties of the eigenvalues gives us sum of eigenvalues is equal to trace of the matrix. Therefore, the missing eigenvalue is 2. Therefore, lambda equal to 2 is a repeated eigenvalue. To find the eigenvectors, we need to find the non-trivial solution of this homogeneous system of equation. So for the case lambda equal to 3, we have A minus 3i equal to the matrix given here. Since determinant of A minus 3i is 0, the echelon form should have the last row to be 0. And it is obvious here that last row will go to 0 in the echelon form, because R3 is minus R2. Therefore, the echelon form reduces to this matrix. Rank is equal to 2, and we have one free variable, that is z. So z equal to k gives us y equal to minus k by 2 and x equal to minus k by 2. So we have the eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to 3 as minus k by 2, minus k by 2 and k. Any non-zero value of k results in a eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to 3. Along with that, if we include the zero vector, that will give us the eigenspace. Therefore, the eigenspace E corresponding to lambda equal to 3 is given by some scalar multiple of minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, 1, where C is any real number. We are considering C to be a real number because the mapping is T is from R3 to R3, therefore the field is the set of reals. Now similarly, for lambda equal to 2, A minus 2i will be the matrix as shown here. Again, this matrix is of rank 2. We find R3 is a multiple of R2. Therefore, it reduces to, the last row reduces to 0. And there it would not be wrong to replace the last row of A minus lambda I equal to 0 for any matrix A. When we are finding the eigenvector, the matrix of A minus lambda I, the last row can always be replaced by 0 since determinant A minus lambda I is 0. Now applying the row transformation, this further reduces to the matrix shown here. We find rank of A minus 2i is 2. And the leading entries are in second and third column, which means y and z are the leading entries. That leaves us with x, which happens to be the free variable. The equations A minus 2i into x equal to 0 results in y equal to 0 and z equal to 0. So as said earlier, x is the free variable, so we have to take x equal to some arbitrary non-zero value. Hence, x equal to k00 will be the set of all eigenvectors. E lambda equal to 2 will be scalar multiple of 100, which is the x-axis. Here, lambda equal to 2 is a repeated eigenvalue, but there is only one independent eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to 2. It may not always be the case. To illustrate that, we'll take another example, T from R3 to R3, where the mapping is defined as shown, and we would like to express the linear transformation in the form of matrix multiplication, and hence we get A equal to 2, 1, minus 2, 2, 3, minus 4, 1, 1, minus 1. This matrix A is nothing but the matrix of the linear transformation with respect to the standard basis. So to find the eigenvalues and the eigenvectors, we find a characteristic equation given by this expression. One can verify that equation 1 will be the characteristic equation. The roots are lambda equal to 2 and lambda equal to 1. Using the properties of eigenvalues, we find that lambda equal to 1 is a repeated eigenvalue. To find eigenvectors, following the previous procedure, we have A minus 2i equal to the matrix given. Rearranging this, we get the echelon form. So A minus 2i into x equal to 0 results in equations 2 and 3. Z is the free variable, and hence z equal to k implies y equal to 2k and x equal to k. So the set of all eigenvectors would be the multiples of 1 to 1. If we include 0 vector to that, we get the eigenspace E at lambda equal to 2, which is the line passing through the origin and 1 to 1. Now for lambda equal to 1, we have A minus I equal to the matrix as shown. We observe rank of this matrix is 1 because second row and the third row are multiples of the first. So the row transformation will give us the following echelon form, and hence we have only one equation given by equation 5. So y and z are the free variables. So we take y equal to k1 and z equal to k2, which gives us x equal to minus k1 plus 2k2. Now for this problem, since there are two free variables, we write the eigenvector in the form of a column matrix as shown, and we separate the variables k1 and k2, which gives us minus k1, k1, 0, plus 2k2, 0, k2. So we can take k1 and k2 as common in each of these column matrix, which results in this. So we find, corresponding to lambda equal to 1, we have two independent eigenvectors, minus 1, 1, 0, and 2, 0, 1. Therefore, the set E1 and E2 are subspaces of R3. The eigen subspaces of R3 for corresponding to lambda equal to 1, a more general representation would be given by equation 8. So we find in these two examples, when we have repeated eigenvalue, we can have more than one independent eigenvector or only one eigenvector. In the subsequent classes, we will find how these two types of problems can help us in identifying whether a matrix can be diagonalized or not. Thank you.